In a car race, car A takes time t less than car B and passes finishing point with velocity v more than velocity with which car B passes that point. Assuming car starts from the rest and travels with constant accelerations A1 and A2 respectively, prove that V is equal to t into square root of A1 and A2. Right? So, from question itself, let's see, check the solution. See solution. From question itself, V2 minus V1 is equal to V and T2 minus T1 is equal to TV assume. Right? Where V is the velocity difference of two cars, because it's given V more than and time T less. So since they both the cars start from rest, so U is equal to 0 and distance covered you can calculate by formula average velocity into time. Average velocity is initial plus final velocity divided by 2 into time, that is 0 plus V over 2 into T. So general formula is V into T by 2, that you can derive from the given data. Now you can write this as, for both the equation distance covers are same because finishing point is same for both the cars. So S is equal to, you can say V1 T1 over 2 for first car, distance traveled by the second car is V2 T2 over 2. You can give this as equation number 3. And since car has to accelerate because both are, and it is given that both the cars are accelerated with constant acceleration A1 and A2, so using equation of motion, that is S is equal to UT plus half AT square, U is 0. So you can write one equation half A1 T1 square, and another equation form you can form for the car A2 T2 whole square. So this I am giving as equation number 4. With the help of these equations you can manipulate. From equation 1 we can write V over T, that is what, V2 minus V1 over T2 minus T1. That V1 V2 value you can choose from the equation this. First car is moving faster, okay. So it is, you can write it as S from the here, you can write 2S over 2S over T2 minus 2S over T1 divided by T2 minus T1. Is it okay? 2S you can take common, so it is T1 T2 T2 T1 minus T2. Fine. This you can cancel. Here is also in denominator you have T2 minus T1. That you can get 2S over T1 minus T2. We are calculating magnitude, so you can put the mod of this. Right. Now A1 into A2, from equation 4 you can write A1 into A2 is equal to 2S over T1 square, 2S over T2 square. Yes, that comes out 4S square over T1 square T2 square. that you can write it as V over T is equal to 2S over T1 T2. That you can of course put V square over T square. So V is equal to T square root A1 A2 will be the answer. You can get the answer like this. Let's take one more example. That will be example number 10. I have not numbered the question of NCERT in our example. So this is example number 10. A car accelerates from rest with uniform acceleration alpha for some time, then deaccelerates uniformly with rate beta and comes to rest. What we have to do here? Number one, plot velocity time graph. Number two, calculate a maximum velocity attained by car. Number B, second part, total distance covered. If capital T is total time taken in the journey. So this is also a good question. Let's have quickly. First is velocity time graph. How do you draw the velocity time graph? First, it accelerates uniformly with time for some time, say T1 with rate alpha, because slope of velocity time graph gives acceleration, then deaccelerates with rate beta and finally comes to rest after time T. This total time taken is capital T. So use equation of motion for first part. V is equal to U plus AT. V is V, U is 0, A is alpha, T is T1. Now this becomes initial velocity for second part of the journey. Final velocity is 0. This is V minus beta T2. From equation 1 and 2, T1 is equal to V over alpha and T2 is equal to V over beta. Therefore, total time T is equal to T1 plus T2, V over alpha plus V over beta. Solve this. V is equal to alpha beta over alpha plus beta into T. Total distance covered, that you can also calculate. What is total distance covered? It's velocity time graph. So how do you calculate total distance covered? Area lying below the curve, maximum velocity is V. So distance is equal to half into area of triangle. I can mark this point O and A. So OA into BC. OA is how much? V. And BC is how much? Capital T. And velocity you have calculated here. So half alpha plus beta into T square. This will be the expression for total distance covered by car in time T. Questions of NCERT which are based on analysis of graphs. So this is first question which says which of the graph represents one dimensional motion. I am talking about 3.6 question. Which represents one dimensional motion? Graph number 1 is not one dimensional motion, because you see a particle occupies two positions at any time. If I choose time t here, you can find there are two positions, position 1 and position 2. So it cannot be one dimensional. Graph 2 is also not representing 1D motion, because at the same time, if this body is moving like this, so velocity at this point will be this, tangentially upward, at this time velocity is downward. So this graph is also not for for one dimensional motion, because velocity of the particles are in two opposite directions at the same time interval. Plus t and minus t, magnitude of time is a scalar quantity, so it doesn't matter. You can take it same time. Graph third shows, again same thing, the speed is negative as well as positive in given interval of time. You can choose any interval of time, say this and this. I can say t1 and t2. So within this interval of time, the velocity is positive as well as negative. This is also not possible. Speed is positive as well as negative. Speed either can be a positive or can be a negative. Fourth graph can be a one-dimensional motion. And this practically shows bouncing of a body from any surface. Right? Another graph is this. Question number 3.9 from NCERT. Here also three graphs are given. One is position time graph, another is velocity time graph, and third is acceleration time graph. And question is, suggest a suitable physical situation for each of the following graph. So the first graph, what is happening? First velocity increases, then velocity reduces, and then it increases in opposite direction, and then it becomes position, body comes to rest. So this graph can be an example of as if any player has a football player has hit the ball from rest, it increases in velocity, which rebounds back from the any surface or wall right in front of it. Now ball starts moving in opposite direction, and after some time the ball comes to a rest. I repeat, this can be an example when ball is hit by any football player. It hit towards the wall, so velocity first increases, a ball rebounds back from the wall, so the direction of velocity changes, and after some time it comes to rest. CD portion of the graph shows body is at rest. This graph can be a physical condition that ball is thrown vertically upward, and then it falls back to the ground, and then bouncing, then keeps on rebouncing. So every time the direction of velocity is changing, and gravity velocity is also reducing with respect to time, and eventually body comes to rest. In this graph, if we look at graph, acceleration is suddenly increases at a certain very short interval of time, and it also changes direction. In this portion, acceleration increases and then suddenly reverses the direction in a fractions of time. That you can see, this is the particularly a time. So this can be an example when ball is accelerating towards any cricket player, and while it hits the batsman or batsman hits the ball, then direction of the ball is suddenly changed. So it can be an example that cricket ball is hit back by the batsman in the ground. There are many conceptual questions you can also see in case of velocity and acceleration, but you can take one more example quickly. If I say velocity time graph of a body is shown below. This is velocity time graph given. Now I can ask you a question, a plot acceleration time graph by using this graph, right? If any scale is given here, okay, say 20 meter per second, this you can say 4, then this you can say 10, this you can say 14, then you can easily plot a graph acceleration time graph. Initially body moves with constant acceleration because slope of the curve measures acceleration, and acceleration is 20 meter per second divided by time interval is 4, so it is 5. So you can mark here 5 meter per second square. How long? Till the time 4 seconds. From 4 to 10 second body moves with constant velocity, so acceleration is 0. Till here acceleration is 0. From 10 to 14 second it reverses its direction, so acceleration goes negative direction but of constant magnitude. So this will be minus 5 meter per second square. Right, apart from that, there are so many conceptual questions which you can be asked or which can be asked, like, is it possible that brakes are applied in a vehicle, or brakes of the vehicle are applied by a driver or someone else, whosoever is driving, and the vehicle stops instantaneously? Can it be practically possible? Answer is no. Instantaneously means because acceleration is V over T. So instantaneously means T tends to 0, then deacceleration must tends to infinity, which is not possible. You cannot deaccelerate a body by infinite deacceleration. So it is not possible for any vehicle that the moment you apply a brake and you will be able to stop the vehicle. Another question, see, is the direction of acceleration is same as the direction of velocity in all situations? Is the direction of acceleration is same as the direction of velocity in all situations? Answer is no. It is not possible. Some cases it can be possible when body is moving linearly. But in this case also is not possible. For example, when you are applying brake, the velocity is reducing, acceleration is acting in opposite direction, that is retardation, that's how it reduces velocity. Third question I can take, is it possible for a body to at a certain point of its motion that velocity becomes zero but acceleration is non-zero? Many examples you can take. Number one, when you throw a body vertically upward at maximum height, when it attains maximum height, its velocity is zero but acceleration acts downward. Anybody is moving parallel to the horizontal with velocity v, right? Velocity is constant but acceleration is again acting in perpendicular direction. In circular motion, velocity of a body at any point is always in the direction of the tangent, however acceleration acts towards the center. So many examples where velocity, as well as this is an example where velocity is zero, acceleration is acting perpendicular and vertically down, so you can also consider as acceleration is finite. This is an example where velocity and acceleration are acting at right angles. Velocity time graph, this is also a question example for velocity time graph. What is happening? I told you how to plot acceleration time graph when velocity time graph is given to you. Here we have few questions to ask. Number one, what is acceleration of part OA? What is acceleration in part OA, OB, sorry, AB, BC and CD, right? And what about part DE? This is question number one. And then total distance covered, total distance and displacement covered by a car or an object, you can say anything, it hardly matters. Now see, from A to O to A, body is accelerating with constant acceleration or uniform acceleration. It acquires velocity 20 meter per second in 5 seconds. So in OA part, acceleration is equal to OA part. Acceleration is equal to V is V2 minus V1 over T2 minus T1. We will use this formula. V2 is 20. Initial is 0. It is time is 5, 0, so it is 4 meter per second square. From A to B, velocity is constant. So no change in velocity. So A to B, V2 minus V1 is 0, so acceleration is 0. B to C, acceleration is reversing because velocity is changing its direction. So B to C, acceleration will be V, same formula, V2 minus V1 over T2 minus T1. Final velocity at 12 seconds is 0. Here it is 20, time is 2 seconds, so it is 10 minus 10 meter per second square. Minus sign of acceleration or any vector quantity just represents that body is moving in opposite direction, right? And then in CD part, body moves on other side from the origin or point from where it is started. I mean to say, this is a point, body first accelerates, then moves with some constant speed, then deaccelerate, passes through this point again after some time, and now it is moving. This is CD part. So in part CD, you can calculate acceleration again by same formula. Final velocity is minus 20, initial is 0, so it is time, is it is moving in opposite direction, so time is again 2 seconds, So it is minus 10 meter per second square. In this case also it is moving in opposite direction. So in which part body is accelerating with higher value, that is BC and CD. AB is uniform, and in between A and B there is no acceleration. What about DE part? In DE part it is not validating in velocity time graph. It is invalid part. You can join it graphically, but it hardly matters, because it says at the same time velocity of the particular object comes out to be zero if I move and draw this point, and which is not possible, as I discussed in the previously in a question. Can it be possible that immediately a car can be stopped by applying brake? Answer was no. So it is validating here also. Now about distance covered. Distance is a scalar quantity. So you have, by velocity time graph, you have to cover area lying below the curve. So all this area trapezium plus this area of triangle. Trapezium of this means AB plus OC into AB. So distance covered, you can calculate S is equal to half AB plus OC into AB. Half AB is how much? AB is 5 and OC is how much? 12. AB is how much? 20. This cancels 10. This is 17, 170 meter. And for displacement, since displacement is a vector quantity, so you have to talk about negative sign also. Then this is the graph portion where velocity body is moving in opposite direction. So this value of the displacement you have to subtract. So area of this is trapezium plus area of triangle also you have to add. That is 20 into 2. That is how much? 10. 20. So total distance is 190. Now when you talk about displacement, this area is displacement in positive direction is 170, displacement is negative direction is minus 20. So 170 minus 20 is 150 meter. So displacement is 150 meter, distance covered is 190 meter. More about this. If in a velocity time graph, say two cars are moving, one starts from rest like this, A, another starts from here, after some time car B. So which car is accelerating faster? Of course B, because this slope is higher than slope of the car B, and you know in velocity time graph, slope, that is the value of tan theta, represents velocity. Sorry, acceleration, right? So B is accelerating faster than. Now at this point, does this point graphically shows that this is the time where two cars are meeting? Answer is no. Answer is no, because this point simply says this is the time interval at which the velocity of two car becomes same. Then how do you find it out numerically that if car A is moving at back of the car B, and at particular time car A overtakes car A? That you have to calculate by calculating distance covered by two cars. So if you want to check whether two bodies are at the same position at a given time or not, so you have to calculate distance covered by two cars from velocity time graph. That will help you out to calculate whether car A is able to overtake at that time or not. So what you have to calculate? Distance covered. This graph of course does not say that, represent that car B overtakes car A. It simply says car B has same velocity at time A as car A. However, they are moving even far apart.